Afternoon, everyone. So before we start, let me check your attendance first. Just say present if you're here. Number one. Number two. Three. Four. Five. Six. Seven.
I'm here.
Eight.
Yes.
Nine.
positive.
Okay, very good. We have the word ecosystem. Number?
Number 15.
Okay, we have the word ecosystem. How about this one? O-M-B-I-E.
Biome.
What word is this? We have biome. Okay, we have biome. And how about this one? What do you think is the word for this? We have the word biosphere. Okay, please remember the six words. We have individual, population, community, ecosystem, biome, and biosphere. Again, individual, population, community, ecosystem, biome, and biosphere. Again, individual. Next to individual, we have. What's next to individual? Anybody? Individual. Next to individual, we have. Population. Next to population, we have. What's next?
Community.
Community. Number 16, right? No.
30.
Mapram, right?
Yes.
Next to community, we have.
Ecosystem.
Ecosystem. Number?
Number 15.
Next to ecosystem, we have.
Bio.
Bio. Number? What's your number?
30.
And next to bio, we have?
Biosphere.
Okay, biosphere. Number?
32.
Bloom, right?
Yes.
Okay. Again, individual, population, community, ecosystem, biome, and biosphere. So here's the ecological organization from individual to biosphere. So you look at the left and the right side of the picture. It will lead you to its own definition by each ecological organization. For example, when you say individual, that means only one, right? So for example, here in the picture, we have one fish. Same as this picture, we have also one individual. But when you talk about population, that means it's still fish, but there's a lot, or there's many in terms of population. For example, let's have individual as one, population is seven. That means that there is a lot of individual in a population. That's for population. For example, here, individual is one, population is three. So there is three individual in this population. They are called as a population. So when you talk about community, that means that different kind of species or type of species or animals. For example, in a community of this, we have a crab, fish, a grass. That is community. It's different. It's a combination of different species. While ecosystem, the only thing that differs ecosystem and community is that in community, it's only more on the living organisms or biotic. While your ecosystem is a combination of biotic and abiotic. Mishiwid, mimishiwid. Okay, that is for ecosystem. The living organisms and the non-living organisms are comprised ecosystem. That's how by the definition. For biome, it's more on the wider scale, it's more broader, and when you talk about the whole thing that is called your biosphere. Okay, let's start with individual. An individual is one organism Your pet cat is an individual. Either you change your pet to dog, snake, rabbit, those are still individual if comprising to one. So your pet cat is an individual. A moose in Canada is an individual also because it's also pertaining to one organism or one individual. A coconut palm tree on an island in the Indian Ocean is an individual. A gray whale crossing in the Pacific Ocean is an individual also. Those are under individual. So I want you to name these following animals. Let's have number one on the left side. What is the name of the animal we have? Still extra points for those who will participate. Number one is what? What is the name of the animal for number one?
Elephant.
Elephant.
Okay, elephant. Number
statistic.
From right. How about the second picture we have?
Tiger.
Tiger. Okay, number? Who answered first? May I get the number or the nickname? Okay. Next, how about this one? Third picture. This is most common, can be seen at school or at home outside as long as there is trees. Can mostly see this one afternoon or morning. What is the name of this animal?
Squirrel.
Okay, squirrel. Number?
40.
40. How about the second picture? What is this? This one, Echo.
Cheetah.
Okay, remember that cheetah. Wait.
Lotus.
Lotus. Number?
16.
16 and? Only number 16, right?
31.
31. How about the second picture?
Orchid.
Orchid. Very good. Number?
21.
21. How about this one? The first picture. You can search if you don't know.
Hibiscus.
Okay, number?
Number 15.
Okay, here we have hibiscus. And the right side of the picture?
Rose.
Rose.
Rose. No.
Rose.
Numbers?
21.
21. What else? Number? I think 33 and 40. Okay, only two. I think I need one more.
29.
Yeah, okay, finished. Okay, how about this one, the white one?
15.
Very good. Number?
15.
18, right?
Plata, 15.
Sipha, shamai?
16.
16. Okay, how about the right side? Okay, I'll just give this one. This one is the red ginger lily or ginger lily. It comes to different variation or variety. It could be a cone shape, circle shape, different shapes and different colors also. Some of the ginger lily population distribution of a population. First, we have a clam. Second, we have a unicorn. Third, we have a random. Again, remember? First, we have, what is the first word? We have clam. Second, we have
unicorn.
Very good. Next, we have
random.
Random. Okay. When you say clam, distributed in clusters. So when you say clusters, those are in groups like this one. When you say uniform, evenly spaced like this one. When you say random, random spacing or like this one. Those are the different population distribution under a population. We have a clumped, a uniform, a random. You look at the picture carefully because I have series of examples. Next slide. I want you to identify whether those examples are clumped, uniform, or random. Okay, the first picture. Elephant. Are they clumped, uniform, or random?
Clumped.
Number? What's your number?
16.
16. Okay, that is clumped. How about second picture?
Uniform.
Uniform number?
29 and 40.
29 and 40. Okay, how about the last one?
Random.
Number?
38.
Next?
29.
29 and?
40.
40. Okay, those are 32.
36.
Clump, uniform, random. Okay, how about this one? The first picture.
Uniform.
Very good. Number?
36
and?
40.
40. How about the second picture?
Random.
Number?
4.
You look at the picture carefully.
Random. Uniform.
Uniform, sure.
Come. I don't know.
Come.
Okay, I'll give you a hint. Okay. If you're looking this one in your screen, it looks like it might be a clump, right? Because it's a group. But if you are here at the top or at the sky, in the sky, if you're riding a airplane or helicopter, let's say, one, and you thing. Is it a clamp, a uniform, or a random?
Random.
Random?
Random.
Okay, I'll find another view. This one.
Uniform.
The answer is?
Uniform.
Uniform. Okay, the answer is uniform. The penguins are in uniform population. Random, and we have a clamp. Okay, these are still population because they are a group of gazelles. So if you're talking about one, that means individual. Talking about one, still individual. But talking as a whole or as a group of gazelles, that is a population already. The same as this one. If one, individual, if all of these are population. Okay, let's move to community. When you talk about community, are made up of all the population of different species in a given area. For example, if this one, we have zebra, we have fish, we have bird. Different population, different kind of species, those are under community. For example, if I would like community number one here. For example, we have bird, dog. Dog. And we have dog also. Human. What else? Cat. Okay, that this one is a community because it is made up of population of different species. Like we have bird, this one we have dog, we have snake, we have cat, we have human. That is community. So next, when you say ecosystem, we discussed this already. This one, the only thing different ecosystem and a population is that in ecosystem we have abiotic factor, which is the non-living component of an ecosystem. So remember, in an ecosystem we have biotic and the abiotic component that makes up an ecosystem. We already discussed this one last week, and we have two types of ecosystem. We have aquatic ecosystem and we have terrestrial ecosystem. So what's the difference? When you say aquatic, that means in water, from the word aqua, water meaning water. Terrestrial, those are living organisms that is inland. Okay, aquatic, the main habitat is in the water. For the main habitat for terrestrial is in the land. That is aquatic and terrestrial ecosystem. Okay, look at the differences between the two. Okay, let's proceed to biome. When you say biome, it's a region of Earth where the climate determines the types of plants that live there. The types of plants in a biome determine the types of animals that live there. For example, okay, the main abiotic factor that characterizes a biome is your climate. So what's the difference between weather versus the climate? So when you talk about weather, it's day to day. For example, rainy, stormy, snowy, sunny. But when you talk about climate, it's the large period of time. So weather, again, is short period of time, or let's just say day to day. For example, today is Wednesday. Wednesday, rainy. Today's rainy. Tomorrow, stormy. The other day, sunny. That is weather. But when you talk about
Shrouded in a blanket of clouds, they awaken. Their canopies of green glitter in the sun. Their wildlife start to slither, chirp, and growl in one of the planet's richest ecosystems. Rainforests are the oldest living ecosystems on the planet. Some can trace their origins to over 70 million years ago, back to a time when dinosaurs still roamed the Earth. While the giant reptiles have disappeared, rainforests continue to thrive, growing on every continent except Antarctica. Two types of rainforests are scattered across the globe, temperate and tropical. Temperate rainforests are mainly found in the mid-latitudes, often near cooler, coastal, mountainous regions. Tropical rainforests are primarily located in warmer climates, between the Tropic of Cancer and the Tropic of Capricorn. As their names imply, temperate and tropical rainforests are the wettest forests on Earth, receiving up to about 33 feet of rain per year. This precipitation plays a critical role in creating an exceptionally lush and biologically diverse habitat. While rainforests only make up about 6% of the Earth's surface area, they are home to over half of the world's plant and animal species. This biodiversity creates benefits that extend far beyond the rainforest boundaries. Rainforest plants produce an assortment of food items, in addition to ingredients useful in everyday products and medicines. In fact, an estimated 70% of the plants used in cancer treatments are only found in rainforests. On an even larger scale, rainforests help to stabilize the planet's climate. Its lush, green vegetation regulate global temperatures by absorbing massive amounts of radiation from the sun. They also absorb vast amounts of carbon dioxide and convert them into oxygen, about 40% of the planet's breathable air. Over the past few centuries, rainforests have disappeared at an alarming rate. Factors such as economic inequalities, human development, and demand for natural resources have fueled the deforestation of these rich ecosystems. At the current rate, rainforests, which have survived for over 70 million years, may completely disappear within the next century. But through educational campaigns, sustainable logging practices, and cooperation with local communities, deforestation may begin to slow down, helping preserve rainforests for many generations to come.
Okay, that is tropical rainforest. So in a tropical rainforest, we have four layers. We have emergent layer, we have canopy layer, we have understory layer, and we have a forest floor layer. Again, we have emergent, canopy, understory, and forest floor. So in emergent layer, these are the please be aware that those are toxic or poisonous. Okay, those are poisonous. So, and the last one we have, biosphere, is a part of the earth where life can exist. So, these are all part of biosphere. These are three categories. We have atmosphere, hydrosphere, and latosphere.